Well, Coach, a few days into practice now, heading towards Akron. How's the team looking coming off that Florida
game? They've been really good. You know, it was a tough one on us, and we struggled a little bit just talking to them on Monday when we got back together, but they overcame that. They bounced back out and had two good days of practice. So we're excited where we're sitting at right now emotionally. I think the leaders are showing up a little bit more, which is a good thing.
One of the things that folks were talking about coming out of that game was the disparity in the run yard. Let's talk about the run game and where you think it stands right now.
Well, I feel like we're trying to do things more physical up front, and we did. I think, if anything, I look back on the ball game, I think I might have abandoned the run game too quickly as we got towards the end of the third and early in the fourth. So that would be the biggest change. If you said something about our run game, I'd say it would be more in my hands than anything our kids did.
A lot of folks have been talking as well, too, about Tyler Bray. Not necessarily, we all know he can sling the football, but his emotional stability and how maybe at the end of the game he got frustrated. Your thoughts on that and how you've worked with him this week on that?
I believe you're probably accurate. I think Tyler got frustrated towards the end of the ball game, as we all did. And that's continued development of our football players. You know, Tyler's been playing really solid football. We got a little bit of affected. Our whole team did. Offensively, we did towards the end of the game. And we've talked about it. We've addressed it. We watch it on film. And we go out and try to correct it. And the smarter we are and the harder we work to correct things, we usually get it done.
Abandoning the run, is that something you realize that's going on as it's happening? Or is that something that you go back and you kind of notice?
You go back. If I had recognized it as it was happening, I probably would have called a few more runs. I thought there were some situations in there where I could have. Then when it went to 14, I felt like maybe not then. But when it was at 7, I probably was a little quick too.
Jim, how do you balance? Obviously, you're going to hang your hat on Justin and CP and those experienced guys in the past game. How do you balance playing the young guys, rolling young guys in so that maybe your guys aren't weary in the second half with the number of snaps?
Well, I think you just have to do it. You just got to put them out there and count on them and trust they'll do it, and making sure when they're out there, I'm aware of who's on the field. That's tougher with the situation we're going right now, trying to play a little bit faster football. In the old days, I'd call a grouping to make sure I knew who I had on the field. Right now, I don't have that, so I got to be conscious of that. And because of that, we probably are not going into the game with the amount of volume that we used to, and we never have.
Do you watch tape of the game with your quarterbacks?
Oh, yeah.
Do you watch all four quarters with them?
Yes.
Tyler said he didn't watch the second half because that wasn't Tennessee.
Well, he's not telling the whole truth on some of that. We watched the game together, yes.
Talk about the difference in the first half offensively and the second half offensively.
Well, I think I'll take it all the way to about 5 minutes on the third when we got the fake field goal, Jimmy, and then we stopped him on the fake punt, and we had it. And I took a shot on that situation. We gave up an intentional grounding. It seems like after that, we got it back, and we had another five-play drive. And I thought that was when I probably should have kept sticking with the run game. It was 20-20 then, and I got a little pass happy. That probably harmed us as much as anything. But I think up until that point, I was pleased. We went back down on that third-quarter drive. We looked really solid. We had good emotional stability to us, and we were playing good football. So I was feeling pretty good right to that point. If we had hit that shot play, I think I might still be feeling good, but we didn't, and things kind of went the wrong way for us.
When you see Tyler getting frustrated, what do you do to try to help in that situation?
Well, you try to calm him down and get him focused on the process of playing quarterback. You know, I talked to him on the phone on the sidelines a lot, and it was difficult, and it's trying to keep his mind on what we're trying to get done, just conversation more than anything else, real mature conversation, and that's what we try to get done. Sometimes it's just tough sometimes when you're in those things and try to tell them what's going on and try to get it resurrected and get it changed, and it wasn't happening quite for us or before.
I think Coach Dooley was saying that sometimes people mistake his body language for lack of caring, and he said nothing could be further from the truth.
I would agree with that 1,000%. This kid cares a tremendous amount about Tennessee football and his own performance. And the deal is that as we continue his development as a quarterback, is keeping it internal and making sure you intellectualize how you're going to change that and keep him going out on the field. I think he cares a great amount about this team and this program.
Do you want him to have a poker face as a quarterback?
I think there's times that's good, but there's times he shows a lot of emotion. I want it to be real. And sometimes when it's real, you got to be careful with it, because it was real on the game and he was a little frustrated and he showed it sometimes. So sometimes you got to keep it close to your vest when things aren't going real good, because a lot of people are watching.
He appears to be so even keeled.
I think he is, Jimmy, for the most part. He's pretty straight line. He's not an emotional rah-rah go crazy guy, but he does show emotion on the field when he makes big plays, misses big throws. You can see that. He wears it on his sleeve, and it is important to him.
The impact on his teammates, do you think that's something as he gets older, understands that better, kind of maybe how he's not responsible for them, but as the quarterback, maybe they will follow him?
Oh, I think he's getting that. I think that we've came a long way in that regard. I believe that he's understanding that more and more. that is a lesson that's hard to keep teaching. As you continue to focus on playing your position, sometimes you're not always aware of what's going on around you. But he's getting better at that, I think.
Antonio Richardson's progress over there, how much is, you know, he had a couple mistakes in the ball game, seemed to settle in a little bit and play a little bit better, at least until maybe the end of the game and everybody struggled a little bit. But how would you assess how he's doing?
I think his development's fine. I think he's right on track to be a heck of a good football player. I don't think he played a poor game at all. I think they played against a pretty good football player on that side of the line. And I think that was the first time he's ever had to do that, play against a really fine defensive lineman. And I think he understands now what it takes to go out and play against those guys. But I think, with that said, I think he competed hard against them.
With the pressure that Florida got, were they, in some cases, was it just them bringing one more, or was it not picking up the blitzes correctly, or was it just kind of a mixed bag of different results that caused
a little mixed bag. We got a little loose. They're a good football team. A couple times, you know, Mike got a little loose on 34, who's a very good pass rusher. I'm trying to shove the ball down the field, so you got to hold up a long time. I don't even know that we get loose. We just got beat at the end of the play. A good player against a good player, and they won on a few of those situations. We had a few MAs, but not a tremendous amount of them schematically.
What do you like about A.J. Johnson in the Wildcats?
Oh, he's physical. He's excited. He brings excitement to us, and he's physical. And he's got a good wiggle to him. He can find the hole. I mean, you guys watched what I watched, and it was this, I didn't have any idea what was going to take place, Jimmy. I just knew he's 250 pounds, and let's put him on the field and see what happens. And we couldn't be happier with that result.
You've got two other guys that can run the Wildcat. Do they all bring something different?
I believe that's true, you know, and that makes it, that's good in one way and difficult in the other, to try to have a backup doing the same things. It's like if something goes wrong, you lose that whole aspect of your offense. But they all have some special qualities to them, and I like them.
How would you assess the way Rajon moved the ball in that game? It seemed like